Hey, it's me, Yatul. This video is all about how you can install OpenVPN on your Ubuntu servers. So as in this video, I already assumed that you know that how you can get access to your servers even using a bash in Windows 10 or using a tool like PuTTY. So first of all, you need to use SSH command to get access to your VPS or dedicated server wherever you want to install the OpenVPN. As in my case, I am using Windows 10 bash. So as I'm already in the server, so first of all, we need to use this command. And this command is also available in the description if you want to directly copy and paste it. Once you run this command, as for the clearance, I am just making a particular directory with the name OpenVPN so we can manage all the files directly from there. So right now I'm in the OpenVPN and I'm pasting this command over here. You can also use this command in the root, and there it can show you your IP address, that your IP address is this. Click OK, and then which protocol you want to use. UDP is fine, as encryption is much better in the case of the UDP. So as make sure that you can note this port as 1194, because you need to enter this port in your firewall, else you are not able to get access to your VPN using OpenVPN client tool. I will show you later that how you can do that. And again here, you can leave it to the current system resolvers, but I prefer to go with the Google DNS. And here, this is a name of a client, like whatever the name you want to choose for your OpenVPN file. Like I selected the Techobia over here. And once you press enter, it will take some time to download the files and install the files, whatever are needed. And once these are done, it is going to make an encryption key for that. As right now you can see on the screen that it is generating a key. This key will take some time because it is a 2048 bit long, and definitely it will take some time. If you want to choose some particular cheap VPS to use it for the VPN, you can go for the DigitalOcean, Linode, or recently I came to know with one particular name, Vulture. Whereas I personally have a very good experience with the DigitalOcean and Linode. And if you want to use some affiliate link, where if you spend $10 and you will get other $10 in your account, you can use the links which I provided to you in the description. This will also help me to get some revenue in my accounts. So actually, why I need this thing, because I was using the Instagram API and I want to bypass the server. There were two methods. First, I will install a VNC server over there and take a remote desktop type of access over there, and then run a Chrome from there to bypass that particular key. But that method is not so good. So I prefer to install a VPN so I can route my entire system to my server IP. As you can see, it is right now installed, and if we go to the root directory, note over here, because it automatically installed the file inside the root, the client name which we choose, we found one .ovpn file over here, as I'm moving it to the OpenVPN for easiness. And right now you have to get access to your server, as on every server we normally use to install openssl. If it is not installed, you can use openssl server installation. And right now I'm going to use some particular free tool. If I can show you, if you open that particular file, that file contain all the certificates, private key, public key, which is associated and automatically match itself for the better security and make a proper handshake over there. If I use the same command again, this command is not executable. We need to execute it as bash. If I execute it over here, you can see we can add another user. We can remove the existing user, and even we can remove OpenVPN. As in my case, when I installed it for the first time, it didn't work for me. So I used third option, remove OpenVPN, and installed the OpenVPN again. And that time it worked exactly fine for me. So as here, I am showing you that how you can create another user. I'm creating another user, Techobia one. In the second case, again, it is not going to generate a new key again. So it is going to make a new user easily. Again, as same as the previously, I am picking up my file from the root directory and copying it here. So if we see right now, we have two OpenVPN files, two different clients over here. So in case if you want to share a particular OpenVPN or your VPN with someone, then in that case, you can share another user, which you can remove anytime. If you want to stop the service or you want to see the status of the service, you can use these commands like server OpenVPN status or service OpenVPN status. And if you want to restart it, you can just simply enter service OpenVPN start or restart. So these are the additional commands if you want to like stop the server in case if this is not in use and only want to restart this service whenever you want to use OpenVPN on your server. So I assume you can install this Filezilla tool, which is free of cost, and access your server IP using SFTP protocol. And once you access, you need to use the port 22 to get access to the server because we are using SSH protocol SFTP. So you have to browse to that particular directory, which in our case inside the root it is OpenVPN, and then you have to download the client file which we generated over there. So you can even download one because we have to use once at a time. So once these files are there, what we have to do, we have to copy these particular files to the configuration directory of the OpenVPN. So now see how we can configure it at our client end in the Windows 10. As once it is installed on your machine, you can use the desktop shortcut and right click on it and go to the properties to see that where your OpenVPN is installed. You need to browse that particular directory where the OpenVPN is, as I am just directly copying the path above to browse that particular directory. We have to go to the OpenVPN and there you see the directory name config. We have to open the config and paste this .ovpn file which we downloaded from the server directly over here. Once it is here, then we need to double click the OpenVPN. Make sure that your port 1194 is added to the firewall. You can use the commands or it depend on your server that which interface you are using. As in my case, I am just accepting it from my GUI. And for the UTP, I am entering 1194 port. And for the IP address, I am going to provide it for all the IP, entire IP range. Like where I'm going to enter 0.0.0.0 so that it can accept all the connections from every IP. So as it is accepted, so if we see like we pasted two particular files. So as I selected the Techobia, the first client which we generated, it will take some time. And once it is connected, you can see this symbol and the IP shown to you is 10.0.0.2. No need to worry about that. In the backend, we are actually connected to the real IP. So right now I'm going to show you what is my IP on the Google. So you can see, yes, we are connected to the same server IP where we installed it. As I'm just hiding the last character because I don't want to reveal this IP. Please give it a thumbs up if you like this video and sub to show your love. Thank you. See you soon in the upcoming video. Bye.